Okay, here we are at Learburg again with Michael. Taking a break from producing our latest DVD on How to Motivate Your Dog. So we send the Q&As, or we have people send Q&As to us, and this particular question comes from Belinda in Ohio. She says, I've seen the Focus Healing DVD, and it brought up a question I have regarding the use of harness for a competition pup in the early months, and then adding in the use of a collar later on, especially in light of leash pressure training. And I'll add an addendum here that there's a good portion of our competition healing video that deals with the subject of leash pressure, just for people that have not seen it. Then we're back to Belinda's question. Does Michael suggest using a harness primarily for a puppy until you begin leash pressure work? And if so, a regular harness as opposed to a no-pull harness? When do you transition a pup out of this?
Very, very good question. So the harness is an integral part of our training system in a couple of ways. So, first way is the harness is a management tool that allows us to get the puppy from point A to point B before they've learned to walk politely on a leash. So we don't teach loose leash walking and the subtleties of finished healing until after we've done leash pressure with the dog. And when we actually step in and teach the dog leash pressure, which is negative reinforcement yielding to the leash, so the dog understands the leash as a signal, we don't teach that until the dog is in a certain point in their development. Most dogs are somewhere between 6 and 10 or 12 months old, I would say, on average. But what we do, it's, the age is less important than the dog's rate of development. And the things that we look for before we teach the dog about leash pressure are that the dog is engaged with the handler, shows an understanding of our communication system, and is motivated to play and interact with the handler. And if that stuff's all going well, the dog's starting to understand training, enjoy training, have a good relationship with their handler, then we can teach them about yielding to the leash, because it's mildly stressful work. So up until that point, we need to be able to move our dog around and get our dog around from place to place without having them rehearse bad behavior on the leash, constantly pulling on a collar and those things, which make the leash pressure work harder. So we use a harness for that. That's one of the methods we use for moving the dog around. We have several management tools, but the harness is one of them. If we're doing a competition puppy, what we do a lot of is we also use the harness for all of our restraint and drive building work. So we have a different, we don't use a no-pull harness because we teach the dog to pull on the harness. We'll hold the dog back on the harness for restrained recalls with the handler. We'll hold the dog back on the harness while we tease them with toys and food to make more motivation. So we use it as a drive building tool. If somebody wasn't interested in using the harness as a drive building tool, then they could absolutely use a no-pull harness to manage their puppy until they got to the point that they were going to do leash pressure work. So there, it's a kind of a double-pronged answer, right? If you intend to use the harness for drive building, then don't use a no-pull harness. If you don't intend to use the harness for restraint and drive building, if you do intend to, then or if you don't, then you can use a no-pull harness for managing the puppy up until the point where you can do leash pressure work.